Studio Mixers. It's Ken, and I'm going to be doing another round of the self-myofascial release, or foam rolling, for the at-home series, the home body series, which is not going to use a foam roller because not everybody has one. So if you don't know what I'm talking about, this is a foam roller. You see these at the gym all the time. This is made for self-massage. Athletes use it a lot, and it's basically a way for you to facilitate a release through the musculature, either for recovery, sometimes actually to help improve mobility in some cases as well. This is a really, really helpful tool. It feels kind of awesome in some places and kind of horrible in others. It's really great. But I trust that that not everybody has one of these at home, so I wanted to give you a series of doing the upper body, but all you need for this one is two tennis balls. That's it. So you'll be able to facilitate the same kind of release using these tennis balls. And like I said in my first video, the first video that I sent out was for the lower body rolling using a tennis ball. Same rules apply here. You can use lacrosse balls, you can use dryer balls, you can use anything that's gonna be able to support a good amount of weight. But I find the tennis balls are that perfect amount of density before they'll give, before it becomes too much pressure. So you'll find that as we go through this, for those of you who do a lot of foam rolling, that in some cases, the tennis balls, you have a lot more adaptability. And you can make it a little easier. And in some ways, this actually gets in there a little bit harder. So as I always say with my foam rolling classes, make sure that you're listening to your intuition. Sometimes you'll hit some areas that might be a little bit painful. If you're feeling like on a scale of 1 to 10, a 10 out of pain, or even a 9, or possibly even an 8, I would say ease up. Ease up, because what happens to a muscle when it starts to feel like it's getting too much pressure, it feels like it's gonna get injured, and so it tenses up against it. It happens when you're on the massage table too. So what does the massage therapist tell you to do? Relax, it's totally fine. So you'll be able to adapt how much pressure you wanna put into it. On a foam roller, some of those things, some of those exercises, you've got your body weight on there, and you can't just make yourself weigh less. So there's not that same kind of adaptability. With a tennis ball, you can absolutely do that. And I'll walk you through some of that stuff as we get through this series. So this is your tennis ball foam rolling series for the upper body. Little side note, something that I found that actually helped my dance career immensely is, you know how they sell the tennis balls in threes? I encourage people to go and buy the full tube of three, because you can have one of them just laying around and do all the foot rolling stuff that I did before, or go into some of those more specific areas. We're gonna be doing a spinal series, and you use those two extra balls. You take a little sock and you put them inside the sock, hopefully a clean one. you put them inside the sock and then you tie it up so the two balls are positioned right next to each other. This is perfect for spinal rolling, which is what we're gonna do today, because they'll be joined together. Some people actually duct tape them together, because you'll have the pressure points right on the sides at the top of the ball going along those braid-like muscles along the sides of the spine, right? And then your spine, the bony part of your spine, can actually relax in the center of the two balls. So it actually is not going to receive pressure. You don't want to be pushing right on that bony area. So I find that's a really great way to get into the muscles that we're going to be targeting today. So going on to the upper body, I wanted to start with an easy area, which is the chest. So find a comfortable place to sit. You can sit on a chair, wherever you want to. Go ahead and grab a tennis ball, and all you're going to do is you're going to go manually onto the chest. There's a way that you can just kind of put your face to the floor and do this. I don't feel like people hold a lot of tension in their chest in a way that putting your full body weight is really going to help out. Your lat, maybe. We won't really be going into the lat too much today. But just manually, if you can relax your arm into an area where you can feel the bones just draping off the neck and relaxing your neck, and just manually taking the tennis ball and just rolling it from the center of your chest, your sternum, out towards your shoulder bones before you start hitting any bony area, there's a lot of area that you might feel really good about. And you can actually go a little bit lower down. The big thing, and I said this a lot in the first video with the lower body, is that the muscle that you're trying, or the series of muscles that you are trying to roll out, must stay relaxed. So my main cue for this one is, as you're doing it, keep this arm just like it fell asleep. You know, like when you fall asleep and you wake up and you're like, I can't move my arm. Don't tell me that doesn't happen to you too. It happens to me all the time. and then you can manage how much pressure you choose to want to put into this. One area that I really love to do is I like to get right underneath, you feel your clavicle, the collarbone, right there. Oh, baby. Right underneath that bone, like For those of you that did not join me for the first video, the lower body, go watch it. But also know that I'm not going to be doing both sides. I encourage people as we go through this, if you find an area, and I'm sure you will when we get to the spine, where you feel like, ooh, that feels really nice, and I'm moving on, pause the video or just ignore me. That's fine too. Just kind of work on the areas that you feel like you need. There may be some areas where I'm kind of working and you don't feel it at all, and you're like, I'm not really feeling this. Go ahead, just move on. It's totally fine. Everybody's going to be mapped out differently. For some people, this is going to be murder. And for some people, this is not going to feel like anything. So find what's right for you. I'm only going to be doing one side, and that's going to be true for a lot of the stuff that I do today. So, moving on. This next part is for your for the upper tracts. It's those muscles right here that when you know people come behind you and they start to massage you, that's where we hold a lot of tension. We're going to go there first, and we're going to use the two tennis balls. This is awesome, if I do say so myself. So, your spine, we're going to take the two tennis balls, go down the spine, go out from the outer part of your shoulders on the upper part. We're going to roll that area, and then we're going to go down the spine as if the two balls were in a sock, right? Like I said before, all the way down to your tailbone, okay? That's going to be our series, and that's going to come in four different stages. But this is a really great practice to go with on a regular basis. So, the first place that I'm going to go is I'm going to lay down on the floor and place the tennis balls right here on the outer portions of my shoulders, okay? Not on the bony process. The acromion process is right there. That's the bony area. Go further in. So when you lay down, like you're going to do bridges, right? Go ahead and place the tennis balls right on that area that your friends would massage for you, right? Right here, you're not going to feel anything, but go ahead and relax. Like the balls are braced where you need them to be. Arms relaxed, neck relaxed, and then go to press the hips up. And you're pushing this way through the heels and trying to relax. So it feels like as I'm pushing this way with my body, I'm letting my shoulder blades fall. I'm feeling like my shoulder blades are climbing down into my back pockets. So nothing is tense, you're just pressing your hips up. And the higher your hips go, the more pressure is gonna go into those tennis balls. So again, check in with your hands, make sure your hands and your arms are not tensing up. And just kind of find the amount of pressure that feels right. So this will be a little less, this will be a little bit more. Find what feels good to you, and make sure everything stays relaxed. Your neck, your shoulders, your arms. And then just breathe. And stay there if you want to. I'm gonna keep on moving. Now just take the two tennis balls and move them closer together. So find another position so it's kind of working its way in towards the spine, and then repeat the same thing. Go and press the hips up. So this is zone one of the spine. This is the shoulder area. And then stay there if you want to, and then move them to where the balls are right next to each other. So side by side. And then my spine is running right down the center of it, and then you do the same thing. Go ahead and press and relax, okay? So right there, I started right here, and I went in, and then I went in. So now the balls are touching, and I'm just kind of pushing into that area, and then keeping the neck relaxed. That's zone one. Find a place for yourself, hang out there, about three, maybe five minutes at the most in one area. Just kind of try and relax. You can massage yourself. Moving on to zone two. Zone two is going to be going from that same place that you just started, right at the base of the cervical spine, and then work your way lower, lower, in between the shoulder blades, okay? So, from there, arms are relaxed, and you can actually just press your hips up and walk your way up as the balls together start to roll down your spine. Arms are relaxed, and then from here, to put a little bit more pressure. I'm not gonna lift the hips. You can if you want to, but that's a lot of pressure in that one small area of the thoracic spine. This is your upper thoracic spine. So what I do is I place my head in my hands, like I'm gonna do a crunch, and then without using anything except for my arms, I'm gonna lift my head and just kind of move the head around. I'm just gonna look for any areas of tension. So the weight of my head is now kind of facilitating that little bit of pressure.
So this is your zone two area, and then again, you can drop the head and then push your body up a little bit more so it goes down to that next set of vertebrae, and then do the same thing. Relax the arms as much as possible as they lift the weight of the head. The head is not holding itself up. Your hands are holding the weight of your head, and you're just kind of moving around. So you're gonna find that the spine is moving because the head is moving, but also the shoulder blades are moving. So now you're into your rhomboids and your traps. And you're just kind of like looking for what feels good. And you can try a couple of different places all the way up. You can also try, if you want to, you can also try moving the arms even bigger, making snow angels. Reaching forward, giving yourself a hug, any of that stuff. Whatever feels good to you, knock it out. Go ahead and do whatever you want to do. Third zone of the spine, we're just going to go further down the spine. So this one, you're going to go down to right underneath your shoulder blades and then work your way through that little area of the mid-back. So for this one, it's a little harder to get the ball where you want it. You can choose to just roll it up the spine if you want to. But in this case, you might find that your ribs are flying open. At this point, those muscles, if you find that one of your bad habits, like a lot of these people, if you find that your ribs are flying open, know that you're not alone. This is one of my bad habits too. But that's usually because this part of your lower traps area is probably overactive. And so this is gonna feel pretty tough for you. And so for this zone, again, arm movement might help a little bit. But you're trying to relax as much as possible and put as much pressure into that area as well. You can also try lifting the head, but that doesn't do much. So this is where we start to transition into lifting into the hips and just kind of moving the hips around, going up and down, and just feeling that pressure along the side of the spine. And then keep on working your way all the way up. You've got to wiggle yourself as the balls roll down to your low back. And that's your zone three. So zone three is kind of like you're just trying to find a way to relax pressure into the balls. You should not need to do anything more because there's plenty of weight in the carriage of your upper of your torso to be able to get that pressure that you want. Zone four, you can add more pressure. Zone four, we're going to move into, and now we are moving into. We're moving into throwing the ball. Hold on one second. Don't do that. We are moving into the low back. So we're going to go all the way down right here into what's called your quadratus lumborum area. Quadratus lumborum is one of the main areas of the low back that I don't want to say that it's a bad part of the back. It's not. It's an area of pain for a lot of people, myself included sometimes. So you're going to lower down into that lower area of the back. Try and find what feels right to you. Sometimes this might be enough pressure in this zone, and then you're working your way all the way down towards the sacrum, right to the top of that iliac crest if you would follow from the last class. And now for this zone four area, the way to increase pressure is to lift one leg, and then lift the other, or you can lift both. And just try to relax as much as possible. Just that pressure and that rocking is really going to help facilitate quite a bit of release in that area. So your QL for my low back people, your quadratus lumborum, there are two muscles that attach from the top of your iliac crest to your spine, like that. They're like diagonal muscles that go up your the spine. Now, and this is probably a good way of looking at pretty much the entire body as you're rolling through this stuff, because that's the last thing I'm going to do with you guys before we go into a stretch. Hang out there as long as you want to. Where your body is feeling pain, like in this case in your quadratus lumborum, if you've got low back pain, know that it's not your low back's fault. This is something that I try to give information as much as possible, because my expertise as a trainer was from post-physical therapy rehabilitation. And so when you feel pain in an area, it doesn't necessarily mean that area is bad. It's usually hurting, unless you got hit by a bus or whatever. It's dealing with a lot of residual pain because it's picking up the slack for another area that's not doing its job, usually, when you're talking about repetitive stress injuries.
So if a muscle below in my hips is not working where it's supposed to, or providing the support that it's supposed to, the next muscle up has to do double duty to try and hold everything together. And that's the muscle that's gonna start to hurt because it's overworking, or it's working at an angle it's not supposed to. In this case, your QL might be really tightening up and very rigid or very painful because your psoas on the other side, your hip flexor, is super tight and not releasing. So you're trying to produce movement from an area that you're not supposed to, or you're trying to generate support from an area that's already restricted. All of that stuff. So giving massage to those kind of areas, let's go into a stretch, into a diamond stretch, just kind of like we did before in the other video. Giving a little bit of release to those areas that are doing the double duty is the best way you have of preventing injuries. So this is mostly injury prevention and repair and recovery. And that's one of the best things about this. Now, from here, take it into a reach across and drop the head, shake the head no. Give yourself a deep breath into the back and go on to the other side. So again, this spine series is another thing, just like the feet, the foot series that I did before, that's really, really good to do on a regular basis. And you'll find that maybe one day one area of your spine is super tight, and then the next day it's a completely different area. Your body is an ever-changing vessel and responding to the things that you do or don't do in your everyday life. I'm taking a side stretch. So it's our job to use myofascial release as a means to do that inventory. Find out what's going on with your body. Figure out what areas are tense. And if all of a sudden the middle of your back is going to a twist, the middle of your back is seizing up, and that zone 2, zone 3 area is really fiery for that, that's a message to you. It's something, your body's going through something. Go and switch to the other side. So doing things like this, or foam rolling, or even stretching, is the best way we have of being aware of the body as it goes through its changes. from adapting to exercises, overwork, or just relaxing too much sometimes. All right, and then go into a hamstring stretch. And just drop the head forward. Give yourself a deep breath. Soon as possible, but stay safe until